So let's make a review of this A5 notebook, YRL best, and it's strange. Let's see what they say. They claim 100 gram square thick paper, that's what they say, and 80 sheet, 160 pages. Okay, this is what they claim, this thickness of the paper. Theoretically, most people want thicker paper because it's more sturdy, right? Let's see. But I want to keep in mind those two numbers, 100 grams, 80 sheet, 160 pages. Now let's open up the notebook. Now, how do you know, how can you prove that is that weight, the paper weight they are telling you is true? Well, you need a scale and you need to do some math numbers, do calculations to see how much should weight this one, because again the name is GSM, stands for grams per square meter. So anyways, it's not easy. So let's take their word, but let me show you why I think they are not telling you the truth. This is a famous brand, French brand, Rodia. Rodia is giving you the same amount, right? 160 pages, and they are telling you my paper is 80 grams, so it's lighter than this paper. Okay, they are upfront telling you my paper is 80 grams. Now, this is a brand new notebook. See how thick is, and let's see how thick is this notebook. Thickness is, you know, you can see it, is maybe a little bit thicker, but just a little bit. Anyways, yes, I at a glance I thought was the same thickness, but not this one. This one is thickness, is thicker, I mean. So yes, maybe it's true, maybe they are telling you the truth with the weight, and it's the only, let's say it, kind of scientific way for me to know. Let's open up dot grid, which is my preferred grid. Pocket. So the pocket is here. I guess this is the back, but it's hard to tell, right? Because if you hold it like this or like this, it's the same. But yes, and wow, it's really nice. Of white, the paper is slightly off white, it's not completely white, but almost nothing. It's, for the most part, is white. The grid is 5 millimeters, it feels really soft, and is not hard cover, is soft cover, which also I like it. I don't care too much for this metal thing they put here. This is for the paper, for the binding, right? But that's okay, it is what it is, right? And just for size comparison, this is a classic Leuchtturm A5, the German, and yes, A5, a little bit taller than the A5. Let me show you. See, it's slightly taller, but in wide width is the same. Maybe smaller, maybe it's like slim. This is official A5. This one is seems to be a little bit narrow and is a little bit taller, But yes, I will post the dimensions so you can take a look. But yes, it's pricey. This one costs like $15. This one depends where you buy it. This is German high quality paper for fountain pens, and you can pay around depends on 10-15. So it's up to you. It's not cheap by any means, but that is not necessarily a bad thing. Thanks for watching.